In order to find the centroid of a composite body x bar and y bar, we first have to divide that composite shape into simple geometrical shape whose centroid are known. Then we have to calculate the area of those individual shapes and then multiply that area with the centroidal value, adding them up for all the simple geometrical shapes and dividing it with the total area of the composite object, we can identify the centroid of the composite structure. So let's get it started. Here we can divide our very first segment as a square having dimensions of 6 inches by 6 inches. So the area of that square will be 36 inches square. Now, since the centroid of the square will be in the middle of it, based on the coordinates system shown here, that will be as negative 3 inches along the x direction and positive 3 inches along the y direction. Now, once we have filled those values in the table, we can go ahead and multiply our x prime and y prime with the area to get the product of the centroid with an area for the individual square here. That is coming negative 108 and 108. After that, we can move to our right angle triangle that is above the square here. The area can be calculated using the formula of the area of triangle, that is half times base times height of that right angle triangle. Here, the base value is 6 inches and the height is 3 inches. So our area is coming 9 inches square. Next, the centroid of the triangle is 1/3 from the higher end of the right angle triangle. So along the x-axis, that will be 1/3 of the 6 inches that we have. Since it is in the negative x direction, that value will be negative 2. Whereas vertically, since our triangle starts at 6 inches above the origin, so it will be 1/3 of 3. However, since that is starting 6 inches above the origin, the value will be 6 plus 1 equals to 7 here. Multiplying the coordinates of centroid negative 2 and 7 with the area 9 gives us the value of negative 18 and 63 respectively. Finally, we have our third segment that is also a right angle triangle having a base of 6 inches and height of 9 inches. So the area can be calculated by multiplying the base and height and dividing it by 2. That is coming 27 inches square. The location of the centroid for that right angle triangle is at a coordinate of 2 inches along the x direction, whereas it is 2/3 of 9 inches, that was our height, so 2/3 of 9 inches will be 6. Once we have the centroid, we can multiply it with the area to get our values of x prime a and y prime a. That is coming 54 and 162 respectively. Now finally, we can go ahead and add all the three areas. So 36 plus 9 plus 27 is equals to 72 inches square. Whereas if we add our component of x prime a for all the three segments, that is coming negative 72. Whereas the value of addition of all the y prime a is coming 333. Once we have those addition, let's plug them back into the formula and calculate our x bar and y bar value. Plugging them there, we are getting an x bar value of negative 1, whereas the value of y bar is coming 4.62 inches. We can also locate the values of x bar and y bar on the composite structure. So since we are going negative 1 inches along the x direction, so I'm moving to the left 1 inches and then moving upward 4.625 inches. So this blue dot is the location of centroid of our composite structure.